in this.
It's like in the A-Team, where they weren't allowed to show somebody getting shot.
Yes!
So you show the gunfire is going past the tires, and they flip the car, and then you have to show the guy crawling out of the car like, oh,
but he's okay. Yeah, everybody's okay. It was like G.I. Joe.
Yeah. Sometimes my nipples fall out of my ass.
And sometimes, Boba Fett.
All right, here we go. Book of Boba Fett, last episode, and in general, the show
just
itself.
Just the end of all this shit.
I have a lot of notes here about the synopsis, but I'm just going to start by putting it all out there.
All right, go ahead.
I have very mixed feelings about this. Very mixed feelings, and I'm going to just lay it out. Because Disney is doing what Disney does.
Yes.
We have something popular. Let's take it and bring it out. Right?
Yes.
Lilo and Stitch? Let's make a dozen more. And now we're at Lilo and Stitch 7, Trouble in Paradise, which is a real thing.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Shit.
There's 30 Lilo and Stitch movies and TV shows.
I believe it.
Yeah. Frozen, Disney Prince... Frozen, Olaf and Gustav sing Christmas carols. Prep and Landing 12, Naughty and Nice.
It's content. It's just content. They're like content for content's sake.
So with at least with George Lucas, you knew what you were gonna get.
Yeah.
I know this is gonna sound hypocritical and douchey because for years we did nothing but bitch and complain about how bad George Lucas is fucking up Star Wars. Okay.
Right.
Please bear with me. I understand that.
I know what I said. I remember everything I said when Phantom Menace came out.
Right. Okay, so Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones were absolute diarrhea.
Right.
They are diarrhea. If you disagree and you think they're good, you're just fucking stupid. I don't have the time or the energy to explain it to you why that is. I assure you, you're fucking stupid. Okay.
Okay.
They were garbage. You could question George Lucas and his artistic and creative choices. You never questioned his motives.
Yes.
From him... It came from a place of sincerity. He was sincere when he said, you know, back in 77, we had limitations with budget and technology or scheduling. I couldn't do it the way I really wanted it to, so I'm doing it the way I really wanted to now. And we'd complain like, fucking money grab. Now I gotta buy the special edition laser disc all over again. He created it. He was invested in it. It was sincere with him.
Yeah.
These fucking Disney execs, it's Lilo and Stitch to them. It's just a fucking commodity. And they're giving it fucking Malcolm talking about Jurassic Park before you even realized what you had. You panned it and you slap it on a lunchbox and you're selling it. And that's what you've done to fucking Star Wars. You've turned it into Lilo and Stitch.
Yes.
And you're going to say, well, fanboys are going to tell us, well, we're getting all this awesome Star Wars content now.
No, you're not.
It's shit Star Wars content.
That's the biggest problem. You're not getting awesome Star Wars content. You're simply getting content. It's just... stuff. There's no artistic creativity in it. There's no
right.
really an attempt.
Let's just to sell tell the a good same story. Product a different way.
Yeah.
It's. They could have let it die so many times and it would have been okay. Or they could have continued it with a little effort. The Harry Potter films.
Yeah.
They're all successful and they're all pretty good or whatever. They're not my thing, but.
I enjoyed them. I do enjoy them, but.
They didn't turn it into a diarrhea-thon.
I guess if you really wanted to look at something like Game of Thrones, and you're looking at something that's based off of something that's already been written, so you have this story that you can follow to create,
yeah.
And as soon as they ran out of story,
it started like, sucking.
We still just have to make content. So just make more shit. I know he didn't write it, so just make shit up. It doesn't matter. Oh, it did matter. It did matter. You ruined it.
You ruined it.
You fucked it all up. And this is what you get. So here we are, Book of Boba Fett, the final episode.
It's just... This is the analogy I was trying to come up with, that I was trying to horseshoe in there. Muhammad Ali was the greatest boxer that ever lived.
Scared of the real man. I'll fuck you till you love me, faggot.
And he pushed it. He kept going when he should have retired. Muhammad Ali, you beat George Foreman.
Right.
Ali Frazier Part 3, the greatest boxing match in history. Step away. He kept going. And you see an old boxer who's pushed it further than he should have. And now you've got Muhammad Ali with permanent brain damage and tremors in his hands and drooling and needing a wheelchair. You're doing that here. You're pushing it. Stop before you ruin it.
Because you're on that path. You are on the path of truly ruining Star Wars. You've already managed to somehow make Star Wars boring. And I didn't know that was possible. Even with the shitty prequels and the sequels, as dumb as it was, at least there was some entertainment to it. I wasn't bored. I was confused, but I wasn't bored. With this, now I'm confused and bored.
It's nothing but fan service. Because they need to just sell something that's already proven and popular. We roll the dice with The Mandalorian, a brand new character. What if they don't like it? You're right. We roll the dice. Let's not roll the dice. Just give them something that we already know is popular and that we know for a fact is going to sell. Okay, Boba Fett. Great. What do we know about Boba Fett? Bounty Hunter? Okay, he's got to do Bounty Hunter stuff. His ship, Slave One, we can't call it that anymore, but add in there. He does the thing with Jabba. Okay, he goes back to Jabba's palace. He gets Han. Harrison Ford doesn't want to do it. He didn't even want to do the sequels. The barge fight with Luke. Okay, put that in there. Stuff that we've already sold you because it's safe. Just sell
just
it again.
Do it some more.
Rather than gamble on a new character or a new storyline. You don't have to do that. You don't have to do any of it.
No, this was definitely a story that did not need to be told. Now, with that said, I like The Mandalorian.
I think The Mandalorian
is pretty good.
It's the best thing on television currently.
And clearly, some real effort went into The Mandalorian. So much so that when Boba Fett was clearly sinking, let's throw in some episodes of The Mandalorian, because at least that'll keep your attention and keep it interesting until we can just wrap this shit up.
I'm really glad we're done with this show. For many reasons. One of them is just, it's the most unpopular shit we do.
Yes.
Nobody watches these fucking reviews. Everybody hates our fucking Boba Fett reviews.
Is it because they hated Boba Fett, or are they like fans like, you can't make fun of Baby Fett?
I think it's that.
Really?
I think it's that. All right.
Really?
Let's get into the episode itself.
Do you understand what they did to this character? This guy was like the most, this ruthless bounty hunter. He murdered people, he tortured people, and then they brought him in here, and they're like, okay, now he's going to become a crime lord, but a nice crime lord.
And a sucky one.
And he's going to solve problems by talking and by loving. He's going to love people so much that they'll just love him back. When he goes into a bar, they give him a helmet full of money. You know why?
Love.
You know, Boba Fett, and you love him. He's just a great guy.
We love the crime lord that runs our city. Yeah.
You sure they're not afraid of him because he's going to kill people? There's like two of them.
Definitely doesn't do that.
It's just him and that girl.
We're more afraid of Mayor McCheese.
Yeah, so, no, they just love this dude so much.
So the episode starts right after the bombing of the bar. There's been a hit. The Pike clan blows up the bar. And they decide, are we going to run away? We got to get out of here. No, we're going to stay and fight.
Right.
We'll probably end up dead. Well, we'll die because we're full of honor and we'll die.
Okay. I also love we should go back to the palace because that's the most fortified position where we will have the advantage. And some 12-year-old goes, I think we should fight right here. You're right. We should fight right here. I think I should kill Cad Bane. And the woman behind him, you shouldn't kill Cad Bane. You're right, I'm not going to kill Cad Bane. What the fuck are you?
We're going to stay and protect the city until the sheriff and his garrison arrive.
Yeah.
Great. I'm mad now because the Pike killed the Sand People. My adopted family that turned me into a Ponzi schoolboy.
Was that supposed to be like some big reveal or something? Or,
I mean, don't know.
I mean, you know, duh.
I don't know.
Come on, Boba.
And then, for a second, I got really scared because we see that X-Wing. I'm like, oh my god.
I did too. Shit, they're going
to
do it,
Luke is coming
to
save the day.
Luke in here.
It's not. It's okay. It's just Grogu. He chose the armor, which you were right. And it makes sense because then you don't have the Mandalorian.
You wouldn't have that show anymore. So you have to have him come back.
Plus, Grogu, therefore, we know, escapes Kylo Ren's rampage at the Jedi school.
That's right. Okay. So that way he can become this really awesome Mandalorian Jedi hybrid.
And we can have another series based on him in 5 years.
Yeah, absolutely.
Why not? Those biker guys?
Yeah.
They called Drash and Scat?
Are they?
fucking Scat?
Well, between Scat and Mayor McCheese, clearly, whoever's in charge of naming new characters is like us.
Go back to Dutch. Just this real language that's so weird it sounds so different that it sounds alien. Yep, just do that.
Because now it really was like they just asked one of us. We need some names.
Scat. Balzac.
Balzac. Well, Mayor. Mayor McCheese. But spell it mock, M-O-K. Mayor Mock Cheese.
Oh, fuck. So everybody's on alert because, oh boy, the fight's coming. The fight's going to go down and everybody's, And then you have the showdown with Cade and Boba Fett.
Right.
Where instead of a showdown, they're just like, fuck you. No, fuck you.
Hey.
All right, bye.
What's your name?
Cad.
Cad. Fuck you, Cad.
And what do you know? All the crime families double-cross him. All of them.
Every single one of them. Because, I mean, you know, Boba is something of a pussy, so...
So if the driving force of this show was Boba Fett leaves the rough lifestyle and he becomes this Svengali, this sophisticated Machiavellian, conniving, manipulative strategist and tactician like the Godfather.
Right.
Get this through your head, you Jew motherfucker, you.
No, you fucking suck at this.
Yes.
They all fucking got the drop on you. You're shit. So you're a shit fighter now. And you're shit at this. Why are we fucking watching you? And why did you have him go down this path of being a crime lord when he fucking sucks at it?
It's really bad.
Every other crime family that we're introduced to, from the Hutts to the Pikes to everybody on the planet, they all beat him. They all outthink him.
He ends up winning by mostly luck. And I think that's really it, really, isn't it?
And violence, but he's not really good at it. So they all double-cross him, and then they're going to negotiate, the Twi'lek is going to negotiate a ceasefire or let us escape, and instead you get the jetpack fight, which looked kind of cool.
Yeah, it was kind of neat. I didn't mind some of the fighting scenes. It was kind of fun to watch.
The action was...
Shooting. Yeah. I mean, they haven't really had... a problem with some of their better action scenes in the show. When they actually get to the action, you know, from like the train heist and
all
that.
It's been mixed.
It's been mixed, but it's been mostly good.
Because the car chase sucked.
Yes, it did.
Him fighting with the sand people. Just
garbage.
Was bad.
Him fighting those guys with the shields.
Yeah, like, oh. It's been mixed with the action
scenes.
He actually
looks like he's doing real karate. And he's like, yeah, yeah, yeah. No, dude, stop that.
I really liked the Ed 209 droids that came out.
Oh, yeah,
the Scorpion droids, they called. But to me, they'll always be Ed 209.
Big Ed 209s.
They were really cool looking.
I liked them.
Yeah, they looked like the droidicas from...
Well, they were. They were like based off the droidicas, but they were big and menacing. They had the shields.
Really cool.
Like, okay.
So you have this...
But there was a problem with it.
Oh, no.
There was a problem. In that they were cool, but they were so useless.
Yeah, they couldn't hit shit.
It didn't. I never felt like anybody was in danger. Because nobody got shot. So when the droidicas are coming through and they're blasting everything in the city, but no one got hit, I was like, oh, they're useless. They're stupid.
More of that to come.
No one's going to get hurt in this.
It's like in the A-Team, where they weren't allowed to show somebody getting shot.
Yes.
So you show the gunfire is going past the tires, and they flip the car, and then you have to show the guy crawling out of the car like, oh
but he's okay. Yeah, everybody's okay. It was like G.I. Joe.
Yeah.
Every time you shoot down a plane, there's the parachute.
Nobody ever gets hit.
We're fine. No, blasters and bullets everywhere, missiles. No one gets hurt. And that's what this was.
And then, boy oh boy, Charles proves to be prophetic. Because here comes fucking Boba Fett riding a fucking Rancor.
I got to imagine him, because he's like, I got an idea, I'll be right back. And he flies away to the palace, which I'm guessing was like half a mile right down the street.
I guess.
He just flies over there, and he's staring, and he goes, fire spray gunship, Rancor. I could take the gunship, which we've seen, will gun down a lot of people real quick. Plus, it's got
with those concussion missiles and the
Or
this animal.
This animal. Fuck it, I'm taking the animal.
I've never ridden this animal before.
This'll be new.
I've heard that you can ride it. Suddenly he knows how to control it. And
I really needed to see Danny Trejo.
I thought it was going to be him.
I was hoping Danny Trejo would be like running behind the rank or going, wait, wait.
With the machetes, and he gets in on the fight. So you have the giant ridiculous fight. And the Rancor gets loose, but anyway, the good guys win.
Big kaiju fight.
Okay, the Pike show up in en masse. There's hundreds of them, and it's just like the three heroes. And like, our skills are no match for their numbers. They're getting their ass, it's clear like, oh boy, we're gonna lose this one.
Right.
Until the guys from Freetown show up. It was 10 guys.
Yeah.
I paused it and counted them. It was 10 guys. So instead of 3 versus 1,000, now it's 13 versus 1,000. Now we're gonna fuck them up. Like, now it's a fair fight? As 10 farmers showed up?
I don't think that's how that works.
That's how it went down.
All right, I guess.
So they win. Okay, they win, and then you have this little throwaway scene where Fennec finally kills Mayor McCheese and the Pike boss, because you had to.
I want to talk about that for just a second. Because it was another moment where Bob was like, I have to get revenge on all this, you know, shit that happened. Fennec, why don't you go and take care of that?
They're hanging out at the surveyor's office. See if you can get there on time.
Fucking hell. Fine.
Okay, you don't want me to stay against these troops that are coming to kill you?
No, go
see if you can get to the
Pick surveyors. Up a gallon of milk on your way back, too, bitch.
Okay.
Fine. Okay, so she goes and just fucking murders everyone. She saves the stupid mods, and then she does it. Hell, she even saves the mods and then do a backflip. And she does a backflip just because.
Yeah.
Just because I can. Hop on her little speeder, drive away, go find the whole, you know, evil family, murder every last one of them.
Oh boy. Excuse me. And then the Mandalorian flies home.
Yeah. flies off to his own show. His own show that doesn't suck so much.
Now, here's something significant. Then we get a post-credit scene of the sheriff in the Bacta tank. And then the mod tattoo guy is getting his torch ready because he's going to turn him into a cyborg of some type.
I guess.
And then the sheriff will come back as a cyborg and have his own spin-off.
It'd be called Sheriff Cyborg.
All right, you'd mentioned nobody ever gets hit. There's 1,000 guns shooting. Shut up! There's 1,000 guns shooting at them, no one ever gets hit.
Right.
No one ever dies, no one ever gets hurt.
Right.
You've retconned anything. Cad Bane, no, he's not dead.
He's not
Boba
dead,
Boba Fett's
fine.
Not dead.
Yeah,
none of Sheriff gets shot, no, just throw him in the back to tank.
He's fine, don't even worry about it. Yeah, Cad Bane, he's gonna show up again. He'd be like, I'm not dead, I'm fine. There are no stakes. Nothing is at stake.
That's exactly what I was gonna say. So if you can have someone cut fucking in half, and then just come back in another series with spider legs. Or someone gets swallowed into the pit where they'll be digested over 1,000 years, and then years later, just his armor doesn't dissolve. Whatever, bring him back.
Whatever, he's fine.
Or someone gets blown away, throw him in the back of the tank. There's no danger for anyone ever.
Yeah.
Who gives a fuck now? What is the fucking point of the Star Wars? There's no stakes. Who cares now? Just throw them in the back to tank. Put robot parts on them. Done. Nobody ever dies.
You know what I really enjoyed? Did you see the movie Serenity?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. I absolutely loved the movie. Regardless of what you think of Joss Whedon and his horrific personality, he made really good movies.
Yeah.
I remember the first time I saw it, when Wash dies, and it was instant like, oh my God, they're all going to die. And from that moment on, like, the stakes were very, very real.
Right.
Because you were like, oh, main character. Shit. Any of these people could die at any moment. And that tension was awesome. And it carried it through the rest of the movie. The show had none of that. Yeah. I never, for a second, felt like anybody was in any real danger.
Bravo. I'm glad you brought that up. That's why The Walking Dead, for several seasons, were so fucking scary and dramatic. Because they were not afraid to kill a main character. It was handled very realistically. Yeah. You are outnumbered thousands to one. Someone's going to get hurt. Even the characters that you love, main characters are going to die. And it happened a lot.
Yeah.
So the stakes were always real. Every episode, your guy could bite it on this one. And it felt, the entire tone of the show was different. And you were watching it very differently. With this, you know.
They're all fine. They're going to be fine. Except the two pig guards, they fell off a cliff stupidly. Because they keep going from, they're really strong. Oh, they're not that strong. Oh, they're really strong. Not really.
They're as strong as we need them to be. In this scene.
And in this scene, they fall off a cliff. Whee! Okay.
So this,
I guess. But nobody cared about them. So, you know, they weren't characters. They were just background props. And then you threw the props off a cliff. And then we were done with that.
This just makes me very unsure about the future of Star Wars in general.
I don't know. I'm pretty sure where it's going. All these characters that you've seen are all going to show up in the big crossover movie event, and it's going to be in theaters, I'll bet you anything. It's going to have Boba Fett and Fennec, and it'll have the Mandalorian, and it'll have all these other characters we've seen. Ahsoka, I think, will be in there, and they're all going to fight for the freedom of Mandalore. That's going to be the big thing.
Yeah. You're probably right. You're probably right. Fuck.
I don't want to be right, but I'm going to be fucking right on this one.
Here's the problem. Here's one problem.
Okay.
We've said before, fan service is not necessarily a bad thing.
That is true. We've seen it handled well. And sometimes it's fine to give fans what they want to see.
Sometimes it is. Okay. Mm-hmm. However, fans are generally stupid. And fans are almost never properly schooled in storytelling.
That's a big one.
Story development. Script writing. Script development. Character development. Character arc, three-act structure, emotional pathos, stakes. You don't just write a fucking movie.
Right.
People go to school to learn how to do this, and then it takes years of working at it to get good at it.
Yes.
This is what made the Avengers films singularly awesome. Because for 15 years, they planned it first. And it's what made the Star Wars sequels singularly garbage. Because they just said, start writing. We paid $4 billion for this. You want to plan? No, we got to have a product movie out next year or we're fucked.
Start filming in 2 months. Let's just get it done.
That is the difference. And that is what you have now. When you just give fans whatever. You know what would be awesome? Oh my God. If he goes like this and he jumps in and out of light speed. Actually, that would be cool, but it wouldn't make sense because we already said, yes, that's true. But who gives a shit? It'll look cool. Let's do it anyway.
I love it. Who gives a shit? Let's do it.
All right. We need somebody, some kind of crossover. How do we tie it back? Well, who's still alive? Vader? No, he's dead. Luke? Luke is still alive. Oh, okay. Where would Luke be in this timeline? I don't know. Building the temple. Let's go. Luke building the temple. Because fans are going to look back and, oh my God, that's the temple. I know what that is.
I know that from another thing.
I'm going to jizz. It's fucking stupid and it makes no sense. It's lazy and it's shitty fucking writing. That's why fans don't fucking write this shit.
In this one scene, Luke and Ahsoka, they'll be together, talk. I can't stop coming. Fuck.
I would not be surprised if Drash and Scat get their own fucking crossover. Streets of Mos Eisley.
Oh, God.
And it takes place, this street gang that trying to make their way through Mos Eisley.
On their awesome street mopeds.
Fuck. I can't anymore. I can't do this shit anymore.
It's so bad. And it won't stop. It won't stop.
It won't stop. And I guess I can understand where Disney's coming from. They're like, fanboys keep buying it. Yeah, you're right.
We're just
fucking fanboys keep buying it. So it's our own fucking fault.
We're going to keep cranking out McCheeses because you guys just keep eating it. So here you go. Have some more fucking McCheeses. It's just content. Stuff for stuff's sake.
I thought they had... I'm trying to make a Star Trek comparison. Because Star Wars was always dumb, fun, action, whatever.
Right.
Star Trek
was always a little bit more thought out. And
it was social commentary. And when they did this to Star Trek, I got much more angry. But now I'm getting just as angry that they're doing it to this.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, when Star Trek came out with a movie that said it was written and directed by the guy that made Fast and Furious 7 or something like that, I was like, what the fuck is happening?
Yep. There you have it.
So there you have it. It's one big pile of whatever.
It's just diarrhea. It's the diarrhea. Okay, here's what's the problem with these Disney streaming Star Wars shits. They look like every fucking piece of shit series that was on Sci-Fi Channel in 1995.
Yeah.
They look like fucking Babylon 5. And they may as well be, because that's how much thought goes into it. That's how good they are. Fuck. Well, you turned this into B5, assholes. Have a nice day.
God damn it. Well, I do want to hear your thoughts, so make sure you leave some comments below. I want to know if you actually did love it. By all means, defend it. Tell me why this was the greatest thing ever on Disney Plus. You're wrong. It's garbage. But we'll listen to you anyway.
And I'm not saying I didn't enjoy moments of this, of these last three episodes particularly.
Sure.
They were fun to watch. But I have to shut my brain off so bad. Just the suspension of disbelief necessary is so stupid. And you have to look past the pandering so much that I don't know that I can do it much more. I can't believe I'm fucking saying this. I don't know that I can do Star Wars like this.
Not like this. I have to hope that whatever it is they're doing next, they put a little more thought and effort into it. That they actually wrote a story, you know, from beginning to end, and are going to tell a story, not just a pile of content and just things that they think will look really cool for the fans.
We haven't had something smart and well done since Rogue One. Since Rogue One. And there was plenty of fan service in that.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. But
so it's fucking possible.
Yes, it is absolutely possible for them to do good Star Wars. They haven't, but they should. I hope.
Fuck. Fucking Disney. Pieces of fucking shit. Fucking House of Mouse, asshole.
God damn it. Well, you know what to do. Just click subscribe, ring the bell, do all that shit.
Eat a dick and fuck off. Just do that.
Just do that. We're going to see you in another episode, and I don't even know what the next thing is.
I don't know. It's not this.
Whatever the next thing is, we're going to be there to rip it a new asshole, so.
No. If it's worth a shit, we'll give it its due praise. But yeah. If it sucks,
I'm going to tell you it sucks. I think the next thing's going to be Moon Knight, so, you know.
Well, we'll do something before Moon Knight.
I don't know what the next thing is.
Well, you're going to start watching Peacemaker.
Oh, I'm going to start watching Peacemaker.
We'll just do that one
I'm actually excited about that one.
So. We'll do that as one big episode, yeah.
He fucking hugs an eagle.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see that.
Yeah, it's great.
It's all great right. Show. We'll see y'all.
Bye now. Do this again.
Oh, God.